Good morning, everyone. We are going to deal with the chapter Union Parliament, the remaining points of it. Yesterday we had started Rajya Sabha, its composition, nominated member, elected member, and election. Now we are going to continue with the terms. The Rajya Sabha is having the term of 6 years. It is known as a permanent house. 1/3 of the total member of the house retire after every 2 years. Qualification and the qualifications for membership and disqualifications. Now, you have to learn it nicely. Presiding officer, like the Lok Sabha, presiding officer is speaker. Same way, the presiding officer is vice president of India. Okay, of the Rajya Sabha, he presides over the meeting. He is known as an ex officio chairman, and in the absence of the president, in the absence of the vice president, the deputy chairman used to perform all the function and the duties of the vice president. Now, powers and functions of the Rajya Sabha and the Lok Sabha. Rajya Sabha has equal power with the Lok Sabha in matters like the impeachment of the president, removal of the vice president, constitutional amendments, and the removal of the judges of the Supreme Court and the High Court. Okay, now we are going to deal with the legislative power. So all bills that other than the money bill can originate in any house of the parliament. No bill can become a law unless agreed by both the house. Now here, so what are the matters here? The parliament can make law here in the matters in the union list, the matters in the concurrent list. Here the concurrent list, in which the state and union both makes the law. In this point, the main important is that if there is a conflict between the union parliament and the state legislature on any law in the list, the union law will prevail. Now, residuary power. The parliament possesses residuary power. It means that it can make law with respect to all those matters which are not mentioned in any three list. Now, matters in the state list. Sometimes the parliament make the law matter related to the state list. When? During the proclamation of emergency, when the Rajya Sabha passes a resolution by the 2/3 majority that a subject in the state has assumed national importance. Next, when two or more states are of the opinion that the parliament should legislate on a subject given in the state list. Now, the ordinance. The president is empowered to promulgate an ordinance at the time when the parliament is not in session. It has the same effect as an act. Power during emergency, when there is total breakdown of the constitutional machinery in the state, or state of emergency is declared by the state. During this period of emergency, the parliament becomes the legislature in the state concerned and assume all the powers. Now, financial power. The money bill can originate in the Lok Sabha. After the money bill is passed by the Lok Sabha, it is sent to the Rajya Sabha for the recommendation, which it must make within 14 days. Now, in this point, and mainly in the financial matter, the Rajya Sabha is having only the advisory role. Okay, now here, the budget. The parliament passes the union budget containing the estimate of the receipt and expenditure of the government for the financial year. The budget is presented in two parts, namely the railway budget and the general budget. Supplementary grants. It is the most, if the amount authorized for the current financial year is not sufficient, the government may make a fresh demand known as a supplementary grants. Now here, third point is vote on account. If the union budget is not passed before the beginning of the new financial year, means April 1st, there would be no money for the executive to spend. There is therefore a device known as vote on account, which authorizes the executive to draw funds from the consolidated funds. until the budget is passed by the parliament. Now here the question arises, what is consolidated fund? So here the consolidated fund is a most important of all government accounts. All revenue received by the government by way of direct taxes or indirect taxes, money borrowed from loans given by the government, flow into the consolidated funds. Okay, now the salaries and the allowances of MPs and ministers are determined by the parliament. Permission of the taxes, no, taxes can be imposed on money spent by the government without the approval of the parliament. Now judicial power. Impeachment of the president. The parliament performs some judicial function. It has a right to remove the president from office through the procedure known as a impeachment. Now removal of the judges. The parliament can remove the judge of the Supreme Court and the High Court and the Chief Election Commissioner and the Comptroller and the Authority General of India if they are found guilt of violation provision of the Constitution. Punishment. The Parliament can punish a person for obstructing the work of the Parliament or showing disrespect to the House. Now here, electoral function. The Indian Parliament has performed certain electoral duties. The Parliament of India, along with the state legislature, elect the President of India, the Vice President. Same way, the Lok Sabha elect its own Speaker and the Deputy Speaker. Thank you.